The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 29th of July, 1971, in Gainesville, Florida.
Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, speaking about the topmost form of yoga system in the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, he has explained the general Hatha Yoga system. Please remember that we are preaching this Krishna Consciousness movement on the authority of Bhagavad Gita. It is nothing manufactured. So, this Bhakti Yoga system is authorized, and if you want to know about God, then you have to adopt this Bhakti Yoga system. Because in the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, it is concluded that the topmost yogi is he who is always thinking of Krishna within himself. Yoginam api sarvesam madbhata antaratmana. Sudhyavan bhajate jumam samai yukta tamomata. When Krishna recommended the yoga system, Ashtanga yoga system, Ashtanga means eightfold, different states of elevation, yam, niyam, asan, pranayam, pratyahar, samadhi, like jnan, dharana. So, the first step of yoga system as recommended by Krishna, the Supreme Authority, is one has to select a very secluded place and sacred place. The Ashtanga yoga meditation cannot be performed in a fashionable city. It is not possible. One has to first of all select a nice place, sacred place. In India, therefore, those who are very serious to practice yoga system, they go to Himalaya, Haridwar, that is also Himalaya. Very secluded place, they remain there alone, and very restrictive process of eating, sleeping, there is no question of making. So, those rules and regulations are very strict, and unless you follow, simply if you make a show of gymnastics, that is not perfection of yoga. Yoga means indriya samyama, to control the senses. If you allow your senses and get sick at it, and if you make a show of yoga practice, that is not successful. It will never be successful. So, you have to select a nice place, sacred place, then you have to sit right angular, and you have to close your eyes, not full, and see on the tip of your nose. You cannot change your asana. There are so many rules and regulations, which is not possible at the present moment. What to speak of at the present moment, even 5,000 years ago, when circumstances of the world was different, and a personality like Arjuna, who was talking with Krishna face to face. Just imagine what is his position. Arjuna belonged to the royal family, You are a great warrior, an intimate friend of Krishna, and constantly living with him. He, after hearing this process of yoga, Ashtanga yoga, he said, "My dear Krishna, it is not possible for us." He flatly said, admitted, that for me, these rules and regulations and practice and controlling the mind is not possible. He flatly said. So we have to think, 5,000 years ago, a personality like Arjuna, he expressed his inability to practice this Ashtanga Yoga system. And what to speak about? Therefore, the conclusion is that in this age, when people are very short living, at least in India, the average duration of life is 35 years. In your country it may be more than that. But actually, as your grandfather lived for 100 years, you cannot live. The things are changing. Especially the duration of life will be reduced. There are predictions in the Shastras. In this age, the duration of life, people's sentiment for becoming merciful, brain substance, in so many ways, they are being reduced. They are not so powerful. So, the duration of age is very small. We are always disturbed. And practically, we have no knowledge about spiritual science. For example, that in this university, not only in this university, there are hundreds and thousands of universities all over the world. There is no department of knowledge where the science of the soul is taught. Actually, we are all spirit soul. In the Bhagavad Gita you understand, Dehi nasmin jatha dehe kaumaram jauvanam jara tatha dehantaram prati dhira satra namahiyat. We are transmigrating from one body to another. Exactly like in our present life, just like all of us present here, we have a body, small baby body. Where is that body? That body is gone. So far I am an old man. I remember that I was a small baby. I still remember when I was about 6 months old. I was lying down on the lap of my eldest sister and she was knitting and I was lying down and playing. I remember. So it is possible for everyone to remember that I had a small body, then that I had a boy's body, then I had a youthful body, now I am in this body. So, where are those bodies? The body is now gone. It is a different body. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Tatha dehantaram prati. Similarly, when I give up this body, then I will have to accept another body. It is very simple to understand. As I have changed so many bodies, not only childhood, babyhood, boyhood, youthhood, according to medical science, we are changing body every second. Imperceptible. So this process, that the soul is permanent, just like I remember my babyhood body, a childhood body. I am the same person, soul, but I have changed so many bodies. Similarly, when ultimately I shall change this body, I shall have to accept another body. This simple formula is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Everyone can think on it. And there must be some scientific research. Recently, I got one letter from a doctor in Toronto. He suggests that there is soul and some correspondence with him. Actually, this is a fact. The soul is there. There are so many proofs, not only in the Vedic literature, but even ordinary experience. The soul is there. And the soul is transmigrating from one body to another. This is going on. But unfortunately, there is no serious study on this subject matter or department of knowledge in universities. This is not very good. Actually, this human form of life is meant for researching this, athata brahma jignasa, the Vedanta Sutra says. This human form of life is meant for searching out about Brahma or the Spirit, Absolute Truth. So, the yoga system means that brahma jignasa, to search out the Brahma principle within this material world, matter and spirit. So that searching out, as recommended in the Bhagavad Gita by Krishna himself, and Arjuna says that the system you are recommending, or the Hatha Yoga system, is not possible for me. But Krishna assured him that Arjuna was the greatest of all yogis. He, I am to say, pacified him by saying that don't bother because you are unable to practice Hatha Yoga system. You are not a yogi. You are the best yogi. You are the best yogi. Why? He gave this formula that yoginam api sarvesam, of all different types of yogis. There are hatha yogi, jnana yogi, dhyana yogi, bhakta yogi, many karma yogi, there are many yogis. But Krishna said, of all the yogis, the one yogi who is constantly thinking of me within himself. Yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaram. Madgata. Krishna says madgata. And simply upon me, Krishna, antaratmana, within the heart. Samaya yuktatama. He is the first class yogi. Now who can think of Krishna always within himself? That is also very easy to understand. If you love somebody, then you can think of him always within you. Otherwise it is not possible. If you love somebody, then naturally you will think of him always. That is described in the Brahma Sangha. Premanyana churita bhakti gilo chanena. Santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti yam shyama sundaram achinta gunastha rupam govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajam. Premanyana churita bhakti vilochane. One who has developed love of God or Krishna. When I speak of Krishna, you should understand God. Premanyana churita bhakti vilochanena. Another name of Krishna is Shyama Sundara. He is Black is like the cloud, but very beautiful. Therefore his name is Samasunda. So in this verse of Brahma Samhita, it is said that the Santa, saintly person, who has developed love for Samasunda, Krishna, Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanena, Santa Sadaiva. Sadaiva means always, constantly. Santa Sadaiva Hridayeshu. Hridayeshu means within the heart. Actually, when one comes to the point of samadhi in yoga system, he thinks of Vishnu form of the Lord within the heart, without any stopping. That is called samadhi. He is absorbed in the thought of Vishnu within the heart. So Krishna, Samasundara, is the original Vishnu. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Ang sarvasya prabhava. Sarvasya means including Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. Everyone. Aham sarvasya prabhava. So he is the original Vishnu. According to Shastra, Vedic literature, he is original Vishnu. Krishna, then his first expansion is Baladev, Baladev expansion, Sankarsan, Sankarsan expansion, Narayana, Narayana expansion, Vishnu, Mahavishnu, Garbhodaka Sai, Kridosa, these are states. So, Krishna is the original Vishnu, Samasundara. So this is the perfect system, Madhagata Antaratmana. Anyone who is thinking of Krishna always within himself, he is first class yogi. If you want perfection in yoga system, don't be satisfied only by practicing a course of asana. You have to go further. Actually, the perfection of yoga system means when you are in samadhi, always thinking of the Vishnu form, of the Lord within your heart, without being disturbed. Therefore the yogis go in a secluded place, and in samadhi, they controlling all the senses and the mind. You have to control the mind, control the senses, and concentrate everything on the form of Vishnu. That is called perfection of yoga. And after that there are other siddhis, astra-siddhis, anima-laghima-praptita. So actually this yoga system is very, very difficult. It may be possible by some solitary man, but for the general mass of people, it is not possible. The general mass of people, that is recommended in the Shastra, that Harir Nama, Harir Nama, Harir Nama Iva Kevalam, Karo Nasteva, 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 Gatiranatha. There is no other alternative. Nasteva, Nasteva. There is no other alternative, no other alternative, no other. Three times. Three times means yoga, jnana and archana. Yoga system, as it was recommended in the Satya Yuga, Kriteja Dhyato Vishnu, that is yoga. Always in meditation of Vishnu, that is called yoga. Kriteja Dhyato Vishnu, Tritayam Jajato Makhai. And in the Trita Yuga, by performing great sacrifices, Jagdan. And in the Dapara Yoga, by temple worship, Kalotar Hari Kirtana. In the Kali Yoga, this age, the present age is called Kali Yoga. Kali Yoga means the age of quarrel and disagreement. Nobody agrees with any other man. Everyone has got his own theory. Everyone has got his own philosophy. So therefore it is called Kali Yuga. And if I don't agree with you, we fight it. Therefore it is called Kali Yuga. So this is the only method recommended in this age. Kalautad Hariki Kana. Simply by chanting the holy name of God, one can attain perfect self-realization, which was attained by the yoga system in the Satya Yuga, which was attained in the Trita Yuga by performing great sacrifices, and which was performed in the Dwapar Yuga by large-scale temple worship. That thing can be attained by the simple method Hari Kirtana. Hari means the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Kirtana, by glorifying Him. This is the method recommended in the Shastras. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 500 years ago, He appeared in a town which is known as Navadvip. It is about 60 miles northern side of Calcutta. People still go there. We have got our temple center there. It is also a sacred pilgrimage. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared there and He started the Sankirtan movement. Mahasankirtan, without any discrimination. And He predicted that this Sankirtan movement would be spread all over the world and the Hare Krishna mantra would be chanted in every village, town on the surface of the globe. So, in pursuance of the order of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, following His footsteps, we are trying to introduce the Sankirtan movement, Hare Krishna, and it is coming out very successfully. Everywhere, I'm especially preaching in the foreign countries, all over Europe, America, Japan, Canada, Australia, I'm traveling, Malaysia, and anywhere I have introduced the Sankirtan movement, there were different centers, or 60 centers, they are being received with great pleasure, just like you saw these boys and girls. I have not imported them from India, but they have taken this movement very seriously. And they will take it, because it appeals to the soul directly. We have got different status of our life, bodily concept of life, mental concept of life, intellectual concept of life, and spiritual concept of life. So, actually we are concerned with the spiritual concept of life. Atata Brahma Vijnana. If you are allured by the bodily concept of life, then we are no better than these dogs and cats and dogs. Jasyatma buddhi kunape siddhata. If we accept that I am this body, then we are no better than the cats and dogs, because their concept of life is like that. When we understand that I am not this body, as Krishna wanted to impress upon Arjuna in the beginning of His teaching of Bhagavad Gita, so first of all try to understand what you are, why you are lamenting in the bodily concept of life. You have to fight. Certainly you have to fight with your brothers and brothers-in-laws and nephews, other side, and you are lamenting. But first of all, understand whether you are body or not. That is the beginning of Bhagavad Gita. He tried to make him understood that you are not body. So these instructions was not for Arjuna, for everyone. We have to first of all learn that I am not this body. I am spirit soul. Aham Brahmasmi. That is Vedic instruction. And as soon as you come to this point, that if you are firmly convinced that you are not this body, that is called Brahma Bhuta state. Brahma realization state. That is knowledge, real knowledge. Knowledge, advancement of knowledge for eating, sleeping, making, that is animal knowledge. The animals also, the dog also knows how to eat, how to sleep, how to mate, and how to defend. See, if our education is only on these points, the dog is eating according to his nature, but we are also eating in a nice place, nicely cooked food in a nice table. But the principle is eating. That is not advancement, that I am eating in a better place, than the dog, therefore I am advanced. But we are eating, that's all. Similarly, sleeping, you may sleep in a very nice apartment, six-story building or 102nd-story building. A dog is lying on his tree. But when he sleeps and when you sleep, there is no difference. You cannot know whether you are sleeping in a skyscraper building or on the ground because you are dreaming something else which has taken you from your bed. You have forgotten that my body is lying there on the bed and now I am flying in the air, dreaming. So, the sleeping by thought, if you improve, that is not advancement of civilization. Similarly, mating. The dog has no social custom. Whenever there is another sea dog, he mates on the sea. And you may go very silently in a secret place, but the mating is there. But people are learning how to mate like dogs. So, in this way defending, the dog has also his defending measures. He has got teeth and nails. He can defend himself. And he might have atom bombs. But the measure is defending, that's all. Therefore, Shastra says that human life is not meant only for these four principles of life, bodily demands. There is another thing. That another thing is brahma-jignasa, adhato brahma-jignasa. A human being should be inquisitive to learn what is absolute truth. So that education is lacking. Therefore, without this brahma-jignasa education, brahma-janati brahma, according to Vedic civilization, a Brahmin is learned, Pandita. A Brahmin is called Pandit because Brahmin means one who knows Brahman. Brahma Janati iti Brahma. Therefore he is called Pandit. In India, the Brahmin is addressed as Pandit. Pandit means a Brahmin is expected to know Brahma. Therefore he is Brahma. Not by birth. Brahma Janati, Janmana Jayate Sudra. By birth everyone is Sudra. Fourth class man. Janmana Jayate Sudra. Samskara Bhavediya. And when he is reformed by the purificatory process, there are Dasavida Samskara, 10 kinds of purificatory process. When one undergoes all these processes. And at last comes to the spiritual master who gives him sacred thread as recognition of his second birth, Bija. Bija means second birth. One birth by the father and mother, and the other birth is by the spiritual master and Vedic knowledge. That is called second birth. Sanskara bhavet bija. At that time he is given chance to study and understand what is Veda. Vedopathad bhavet vipra. By studying very nicely all the Vedas, one becomes vipra. And then, when he actually realizes what is Brahma and his relationship with him, then he becomes a Brahma. And about that situation, when from Brahma understanding, impersonal Brahma understanding, he comes to the platform of understanding Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he becomes a Vaishnava. This is the process. That is the perfectional process. Krishna therefore says in the Bhagavad Gita, Janma karma me dibbam jyo janati tata. Anyone who knows me in truth, what happens to him? Tatta deham punar janma naiti. Such person, after giving up this body, do not come back again in this material world, to accept a material world. Then what happens to him? Mind, he comes to me, back to home, back to Godhead. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is directly giving people how to understand Krishna. Janma karma me dibbam. Jo janati tattva, tattva saying truth. So, we are giving Krishna knowledge based on this authorized scripture, Bhagavad Gita, Vedas. Vedas means knowledge. And what is it? Vedanta means the ultimate end of knowledge. What is that end of knowledge? That is Krishna. Vedaishta sadvai ahameva vidyam. By all the Vedas, the ultimate conclusion should be Krishna. Bahunam janmanam ante. This conclusion comes after many, many births. Bahunam janmanam ante. Jnanava. After culturing knowledge for many, many births, when actually one becomes wise, then Bahunam janmanam ante jnana mala prabhadate, he surrenders unto Krishna. How he surrenders? Because he knows Vasudeva sarvamiti. Vasudeva Krishna is everything. Whatever we see, it is simply manifestation of the energy of Vasudeva. One must be convinced on this fact, and then he becomes a devotee, prabhadam. Krishna therefore advises that you understand or not understand. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. Simply surrender unto. So what Krishna taught in the Bhagavad Gita, we are teaching the same thing without any different manufactured ideas. That is our Krishna consciousness movement. And it is open to everyone. The process is very simple. We have got our center here. If you want to take advantage of this movement, you are welcome. You'll be happy. Thank you very much.